So here's the palette that Nick created running in an actual Android app. The first thing I did was create a colors.xml file containing the colors that I wanted to specify. For the names, I used what was listed in the material design guidelines, so indigo 300, indigo 500, 700, and pink A200, and then used the hexadecimal values for those colors. In the style for my app, I used those identifiers prefixed by @color and a slash for my color primary, primary dark, and the accent color. This makes it a whole lot more readable, and you only have to change colors in one place, your colors.xml file. In the XML for our view, we can specify those identifiers in a couple different ways. So we can see here, we set our app bar layout, that's the container that holds our app bar, to have a background with the primary color. Now the reason why we have this question mark here is that color primary refers to a theme local attribute. We could have also listed ?attr/color primary. So if we look at the floating action button, you might notice that there isn't any designation of color information here. That's because behind the scenes, it assigns the color accent value if you specified it. So check out this link, which is also specified in the instructor's notes, to see what other attributes you can change and customize in Material Design.